Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield Blind. We made it back. We've been on Neon for the last 24 episodes. Docking. And so I regret to inform everyone that anyone that was enjoying my random grenade throwing, I've managed to disable that button. It's the back button. It's funny because it's the way I hold the mouse. Like, the button in front, closer to, you know, closer to me, is the forward button. That doesn't do anything. Maybe I press that sometimes because it doesn't do anything, so who knows, right? But it's the button above that that's actually a back button. And I guess it hits the letter G because I have G for grenade. I don't know. Boarding.
It's good to be back on board.
So, huh? Mm-hmm. These people aren't that nice to us sometimes. Hello there.
Soon, everyone is going to learn to fear the fleet.
Hi.
All hell's breaking loose, Rook. Delgado needs you in the repair bay with Jazz as soon as possible.
Okay. Don't you want to hear what happened in Neon?
Hooray! You got the conduction gizmo. You did exactly what we asked you to do. Good work, pat on the head.
Oh, I want to kill her.
Are you ignoring me or something? I just said there's an emergency.
It doesn't have anything to do with me. When is someone going to stop calling me a rook? I did the job. I deserve the respect.
Respect? That's why you're here?
That's right. I came to get
Look
some
around
RSPCT.
You. The only reason all these losers are here is to earn credits or die trying. When I feel like you've earned it, I'll stop calling you rook. Right now, we've got a crisis on our hands.
I'm not concerned about the crisis. Did someone overcook a potato in the microwave or something?
Oh, that's hilarious.
She liked that.
You're a real comedian, you know that?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Now get your ass to the repair bay. Go!
What if I don't want to go to the repair bay? Why don't you go to the repair bay?
Better get a move on before Dale sees you slacking. We'll have the whole settled systems on the run someday.
I want him to see me slacking, but
our bug has something strong enough to
nothing really
know.
Else to do, but
smuggling
that.
It's a real job any day.
Yeah, I don't like these people.
I know it's difficult to resist, but try not to pick any fights while we're here.
No promises on that. Fix. All these, is this stuff that has to be fixed?
Too many missions, not enough time.
We'll get a move on then.
And you are sure we will have those defense batteries up and running?
No. I'm not sure. They're in bad shape, Del. Really bad shape. I'm already using duct tape and spit to keep the station from falling apart, and you want me to pull a rabbit out of my hat?
I don't want to hear excuses.
She runs
I
right
want
up.
To hear that it's going to be fixed. Period. Get it done.
All right. I'm on it.
You want to quit standing there and hand over the conduction grid data?
I wasn't going to interrupt your conversation. I don't know what you're talking about. Getting this wasn't easy, you know. I know you don't care.
Wow. Really?
Oh, you don't care either.
You know what else isn't easy? Listening to complaints and excuses. From everyone.
Alright, I get it. Just hand over the tech.
Alright, listen up because I don't want to repeat this twice. We've gotten word that UC SysDef is massing somewhere nearby for an attack on the key. While we prepare for their arrival, I want you to head straight for Bannock 4 and bring Crixus' legacy home.
Crixus' legacy home? How do you know that SysDef is massing for an attack?
I have a very reliable source at MAST.
Oh, you do?
They were so concerned that the threat was real, they actually jumped the information out to us right away.
I should go check in with Akande and them. Of course I did. I'm thinking that, I'm not saying it to him. Why is Crix's legacy so important?
Oh my god. Haven't you been paying attention?
Now tell me again.
The only reason half the fleet's captains haven't scattered across the settled systems is because they're waiting for their part of the score. No money means no protection. No protection means we are done when SysDef arrives. Simple enough for you?
Alright. Okay. Tell me exactly what you need me to do.
Lay it out, Jess.
Alright, first things first. I'm gonna upload this data you snagged from Genardyne into the Key's databanks.
Okay.
All you need to do is build and then install a conduction grid module onto your ship. Oh, and if you haven't already, you'll need the comm spike module installed as well.
While we're at it, perhaps we should fetch your groceries for you as well?
What?
Once your ship is ready, jump out to Bannock 4, board the Legacy, and bring us the cash.
The cash. Bring me the cash. Carry that much digital data, I'll need some data core. Yeah, I mean, the other thing is a ship, I thought. So I don't know how to... It doesn't sound simple. I don't know how to make this stuff, put it on my ship. Where do I build the ship modules I need?
Everything you'll need for ship repair and construction is down in Jess's section of the key.
That's here. If
you have any questions about the modules, she'll have all the answers.
Okay. What if nothing's there when I get to Bannock 4?
You better pray that isn't the case, because that means we are done. As in, no more Crimson Fleet.
To carry that much digital data, though, I'll need some sort of high-capacity storage device like a data core.
Exactly. I already have one ready for you.
Give it to me.
After you board the Legacy, be on the lookout for two transfer modules. They're special keys that allow access to the ship's vault. Once you locate the vault's control center, hook up the data core, and download everything they've got.
And before you get any bright ideas, like running off with the money, that currency is going to be heavily encrypted. Only a genius like Shinya will be able to crack that encryption. So bring it back here right away.
Huh. What if Shinya is really working for me, right? Why will I need two transfer modules to open the vault? Yeah, I caught that.
Because those Galbank ships were carrying so much money they didn't even trust their own crew.
What if Shinya can't crack the encryption?
That would be a first. I have yet to see encrypted currency that Shinya could not manipulate within hours. I mean, the guy plugs his body directly into his mainframe. He eats, breathes, and shits numbers all day. I'm not worried about it.
Okay. Well, you can count on me.
Yeah? I sure hope so.
Can I count on you, though?
I'm gonna make this real simple for you.
Oh, goody.
If that money ends up anywhere but the key, I will hunt you down and pry it out of your dead hands myself.
Is that a promise?
Now get moving.
Yeah, these guys are jerks. What's your biggest worry regarding the upcoming attack? I hope I don't have to attack. I need to go talk to Akande and them, so maybe they won't attack me.
The toughest nut to crack is if UC SysDef brings in the Vigilance. That Commander Ikande has himself a hell of a ship there.
Oh, is that?
Advanced shield tech, bristling with weapons. I would love to see that thing burn.
I never heard of that
guy.
We
hope to stand a chance against it. We need those defensive batteries. And Crix's legacy.
Is there more to Crix's legacy than just the money?
The Crimson Fleet isn't really a fleet. It's an ideal. A principle that Crix sought to set up so that pirates didn't infight over scraps. Over time, that notion has been lost. Captains have been turning their backs on the fleet, doing jobs on the side, killing each other. Mm. Bringing Crix's legacy back to the fleet would be like validating everything Jasper Crix believed in. And I'm certain it would unify us once again. Of course, it wouldn't exactly hurt to have all that extra money at our disposal. But I think you catch my meaning.
Mm-hmm. Who are these captains you keep mentioning?
You've met some of them already. Mathis Castillo, Yevgeny Rokov, Juan Dayu, Estelle Vincent, and Admiral Kemp.
And Estelle Vincent,
they might feel like independents to you.
I don't remember the others.
Each one of them has a stake in the Crimson Fleet. And each one of them wants a cut of the wealth. Mm. I am sending word out to every able-bodied captain that they are needed. We'll see how many answer the call.
Okay.
Come back with Crix's legacy. Or don't come back at all.
I don't think you want me not coming back at all.
I need to get those defensive batteries online, so make this fast.
How will the comm spike module help me find the legacy?
The comm spike traces and decrypts coded signals. As long as you have the transponder ID, you can track pretty much anything. That file you lifted from the Galbank archives contained the legacy's transponder code, which I'll program into your nav system. All you have to do is get within the vicinity of Bannock 4, and the comm spike will automatically point you to the target. Cute toy, huh?
Yeah. And how will the conduction grid module help me get to the legacy?
Well, you already know that the conduction grid does a pretty nifty trick. Mm-hmm. It absorbs extreme voltage and converts it to usable power on Neon.
Correct.
The version for your ship can still absorb incoming electrical energy, like, say, the EM field surrounding Bannock 4. But it can't store the power. Instead, it just scatters the EM harmlessly away from the hull, insulating you from frying every circuit aboard.
Huh.
As a nice side effect, I'm betting the module will make your ship somewhat EM weapon resistant and boost its shield regen. Lucky you.
That's pretty sweet. What can you tell me about the Key's defensive batteries?
There are three defensive batteries, basically high-powered military space turrets, triangulated around the Key.
Hmm.
They were part of the UC's original defenses for the station. Pretty effective, too. Can put some serious hurt on enemy spacecraft. The good news is that the batteries have an incredibly wide field of coverage, so they can pick off ships trying to reach the Key from any vector. The bad news is that they're 100-year-old tech. They keep breaking down and are expensive as hell to keep operational.
Okay. Help me with my ship?
Not a problem. Conduction grid data is all set up in the system, so it should be an easy install.
Okay. Does my ship need repair? Let me see.
I'd love to take your money, but your ship's in perfect condition.
Okay, cool. View and modify ships?
Sounds like fun. Let's see what I've got.
Okay, so... Ship upgrade mode allows you to make improvements to your ship without needing to worry about where modules should be placed. Some upgrades may have level of skill requirements. Multiple upgrades can be made and their costs will be added up at the end of the session. I think I should upgrade my shields. Okay, so I've got better shields. I got a 30S shield protector. Wait. Oh, is that because I have both of them? How do I move this? Next category? It says I have 30. Okay. Reactors? Engines. I can't upgrade that. Otherwise, we got cannon, missile launcher, and laser. A reactor. Provides power to ship systems. Oh, okay. I got a better reactor now, so she can provide power to more things, I'm thinking. I don't have to keep powering down something to put the grav drive on. Should I just upgrade everything? You can compare here. Better range, otherwise it's not that great, right? Fire rate is bad, but look at the damage. I wasn't expecting to be upgrading my ship right now. It goes with this one. Same range and fire rate, but better damage. Okay. That's the cannon. What I thought it was. Missile launcher, CE. Yeah, that's the one. I was just looking through all this stuff. That was the one I did? Or I did this one? Not sure. What about laser? Oh, you can put all the... It's giving me all. Right, I got molar, 105 can. Okay, so that's a molar, 104 cannon. This is a ATAL, whatever, missile launcher. atlatl, whatever. And this is a pulse laser. Well, I want some other. So you can put just any kind of laser there. Fire rate, better damage. This one's really good. I don't know anything about electron beam. Okay. So then I go exit. The engines I can't. I go exit. Confirm modification, no warnings encountered. So I guess they're on now, and yeah, look. Nice. Okay, good.
This better be important.
You think it's important? I'm not done with her. What's it say? I've been informed that UC Systef is massing for an attack on the key in order to obtain the money to secure enough reinforcements to hold Systef off. I'm to continue to Bannock 4 and retrieve Crix's legacy. Install both the comm spike module. Alright, so she's gotta help me do that.
I need to get those defensive batteries online, so make this not a problem. I bet you would.
So how do I install these modules? Do anything with the grab drive. I don't know how to do it. How do I do it? Registered. Well, it just does that. Ship builder, I guess we have to go into. I have to add a module. Options. Okay. Add. Okay, that's okay. Reactors. Habitats. Upgrade to increase your jump range. Three errors. What are the errors? I know what the errors are. Flight check? Ship is too heavy to grav jump. Reduce mass or increase grav jump thrust. Only one grav. Only one grab drive is allowed. Ship has unattached modules. Low mobility. Reduced mass or add engines. Alright, so I need to take the other module off. Obviously. Okay, that's the one we got. That's the one we just got. NG-160. Landing gear. So where's the other grav drive? Oh wait. There's my other one. Class A, max power is 8. Grav jump thrust 20. So this is the, oh wait, this is the new one then. Grav drive health hull. Okay. Okay, so I deleted out this one. Now I got one warning. Reduce mass or add engines to improve mobility. Didn't I just improve the engine? So maybe I've installed an engine that is faster but can't. Like pull as much? Engine thrust? Maneuvering thrust? Or is that always an issue? Plus, I know I still have to put these modules in. Dockers. Oh. I thought it was an engines. So I have the 2000? Hold on. White Dwarf 2000, right? Wasting money, cause max power is 3 for everything. Class A. Oh, I need a starship design skill to install these engines. Looking at the engine thrust is highest here, and maneuvering thrust highest there. So what if I get this? Nova 1000? That's not what I have, right? I keep forgetting the name. It's a white dwarf, right? One error. Ship contains modules that exceed reactor class. So I have to... That's why they have the upgrade thing. So... Can I upgrade the reactor? That's the reactor. 360T stellar reactor. I can change the color of it. Attach. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. Don't know what I'm doing. Stellar. So let me compare. Hold on a second. Alright, so we're gonna go add. I have a 362 stellar raider. Alright. No good, huh? Z machine. Makes me think of the Infocom games. They used the Z machine basically like an engine, but it was a text only games. Z machine, named after Zork. Their first game and most popular. Well, to have that engine, we have to install a bigger reactor than this, and we can't do that without a piloting rank 3 or 4. I'm gonna cancel. I have a warning, right? I have too much stuff. So maybe I just need to get rid of some stuff. I don't know what to tell you about that. Reduce mass or add engines. Does it say on it? Okay. So here it's saying the reactor is A. So what it looks like I need to do is just add any kind of engine that's an A type. That's what I'm guessing. So I want to add. All right, keep in mind I have the White Dwarf 2000. All right, I have that engine. Is the 2010 engine. Oh wait, the Nova wouldn't work. Wait, oh, cause it's class B, right? I think we need class A to match the reactor. So these are all A except for this last one, and that's the one I chose. So let's try the White Dwarf 2010 engine. Oh, I need to buy two engines? Yeah, look at that. Okay. Still getting the error, but we're gonna add another White Dwarf 2010. Somewhere on it, as long as I can turn it so I can see it. I still have an error. Ship has unattached modules. Alright, so at least I'm no longer getting the error that I'm overweight or something. What's... oh. What's not attached? I mean, granted, it doesn't look like... I need to turn that, don't I? I think. Pan. Because this will fit like this, right? That's not right. I need to turn it. How do I turn it? Oh, flip? Z is flip. Wait. I gotta hold it and flip. Getting nominal. Nice. I'm so excited. I still haven't attached the modules that she wants me to do.